Hi, my name is Matthias. In this video I will teach you how to play Selena Gomez Wolves. You can download the tab, the lyrics and all the chords for this song from my Patreon page if you would like to. The first part of the video gonna be the play-along track with the tabs, the chord symbols and the strumming patterns. But if you would like to, you can jump to the tutorial part, which gonna be the second part of this video. And in the description, you will find the time code. I hope you're gonna like it. So let's talk about the intro. The first note what we have to pick is on the low E string, 8th fret with your index finger, and you will pluck it with your thumb. The next note, the second note, gonna be on the same fret but on the G string, 2nd finger, and you have to pluck it with your index finger. The next note will be the bass, 7th fret on the low E string, 1st finger, and you have to pluck it with your thumb again. So the next note gonna be the open B string. After that, you have to pluck the bass again, the G string, 7th fret, with your index finger again, and the bass again. So the first bar sounds like this. One more time slower. In the next bar, the first note will be the 10th fret on the low E string, index finger. And you have to pluck it with your thumb. The next note will be the 11th fret on the G string, third finger. And I pluck it with my index finger. You have to pluck again the bass. And after, with your middle finger, the B open string. After the bass, after the 11th fret on the G string with your index finger, and after the bass again. So the second bar goes like this. One more time slower. Let's play the first two bars together. Okay, so the first note in the third bar gonna be on the low E string, third fret, with your index finger, and you have to pluck it with your thumb. The next note will be on the G string, 4th fret, 3rd finger, and I will pluck it with my index finger. So, the next note will be the bass again, with your thumb. And after that, you have to pluck with your middle finger the open B string. The next note will be the bass again, and the G string 4th fret again with your index finger, and the bass once more. So the third bar goes like this. One more time slower. In the last bar, we will keep the bass. So the first note will be that note on the low E string, 3rd fret, and you have to pluck it with your thumb. The next note will be the same on the G string, 4th fret, and index finger. The third note will be on the B string, 3rd fret. I will pluck it with my middle finger and slide up to the 5th fret on the B string. So, one more time slower. The next note will be the same note, but this time you have to pluck it with your index finger. So, B string, 5th fret. After the high E string with your middle finger. So, index finger and middle finger, the open E string. The last two notes in the last bar will be on the 3rd fret on the B string, 3rd fret, and I will pluck it with my index finger, and the last note will be the 2nd fret on the B string and middle finger, right hand. So the last bar goes like this. One more time slower. Let's play the whole intro all together. One more time slower. Okay, This was the intro, and actually in the verse, you have to play the same. Let's jump into the next part, which is the pre-chorus. The first chord, what we need in the pre-chorus, is B minor chord. The second chord gonna be D major. The second chord gonna be D major. The last chord will be G. Okay, the strumming pattern goes like this. Down, down, up, up, down, up, 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 down. One more time, slower. Down, down, up, up, down, up, 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 down, down, up, up, down, up. This was the pre-chorus. The next part in this song is the chorus. The first chord, what we need here, is the G major chord. Here you can play any kinds of G chord, but this is the easier, so this is why I use this open G chord. You can play this one or the bar chord as well, it's up to you. So, G major chord. The next chord is A major. The third one will be B minor chord. And we have one more new chord here, which is the D major. So, the strumming pattern goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. One more time. But the last chord will be the D major. Repeat the whole part. Let's play one more time slower. 1, 2, 3, 4. Down, down, up, up, down, up, 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 down, down, up, up, down, up. So this was the chorus. We have only one new part in this song, and that one is the drop part or the interlude. So the chords will be the same. G major, A major chord, B minor, and D major. The strumming pattern goes like this. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up. One more time. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up. So after this part, we have to play again the verse. After the verse, we have one more pre-chorus and one more chorus. And after the second chorus, the drop or the interlude part comes again. And the last part in this song is the chorus again. But here I just play every chorus on the first beat to make this song easier. So it sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. four, two, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, two, two, three, four. So actually I play the same chords. I just pick once each chord. So this is the whole song. I hope every part is clear. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. Don't forget that you can download the tab from my Patreon page. If you enjoyed the video, give me a thumbs up and share with your friends and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye.